Before seeing very interesting significant table about the portions that we read on Sabbaths and synagogues, which is called Parah Adumah, the red cow, let us see what the Torah says about this red cow, what should be done with her, and what is the Midrash says about it. So this is really what the Torah says in Numbers 19:1 till 19:5. So this is a ritual law that the Lord has commanded, instruct the Israelites people to bring you a red cow without blemish, in which there is no defect, and on which no yoke has been laid. The cow shall be burned in its sight, its hide, flesh, and blood shall be burned, its dung included. Now, then there is a verse 5 which says the following: a ritually clean person shall gather the cow's ashes and place them outside a clean place. Numbers. So the Midrash says, one can see it, Midrash, Numbers 19, that this really burning of the cow is a symbol of the burning of Jews all over history, definitely because transcending the Torah, and Holocaust massacres, pogroms, all really basically are symbolized by the red cow. Red represents sins, transgressions. And the Midrash says about all this, what you see here, the Torah describes the cow, no blemish, there is no defect, and no yoke has been laid. So this Midrash says Israel is a symbol of Jewish people, right? This should be originally no blemish, no defect, but unfortunately, it came a time that no yoke has been laid. The Midrash says did not accept of them that the yoke of Torah, did not keep the Sabbath and so on. And then, as a result, this is what is going to be this: the hide, the flesh, and blood shall be burned, its dung included. So we see just now the interesting explanation why the Torah have to specify. The Torah could write, burn the whole cow. Why do we have to specify hide, flesh, blood? What for? Dung. That is important. So let us see here what the Midrash says. Really, basically, it is interesting. The slaughtering and burning of the red cow, according to the Midrash, represent all the program and massacres Jews went through. The burning of the skin, flesh, blood, dung symbolize the four groups of Jews. This is what Rabbi Lapian said. Rabbi Eliyahu heard it from him, but it is also in his book, Numbers Chukat. So he said clearly that the story of the burning of the different parts of the cow represent the four groups of Jewish people. What are the four groups? So the hide are those people who keeps the Jews, the nation, economically with money, like the skin definitely keeps the body. Flesh represents people who are learning Torah, studying Torah. Blood represents the rabbis who give the oxygen, teaching the people. The dung represents the Jews who unfortunately try to take, to go out of their nation by accepting Christianity as a nation. Reform, simple, the leave in Hebrew, dung is perish, poresh. Yeah, they were to separate themselves from Jews. So this is exactly what happened at the time of Hitler. Many Jews converted to Christianity and Reform, but when Hitler, his name should be blotted, when he found out that this person has connection with Jewish, like this, grandmother was Jewish, so he also threw them into the furnace. And this is exactly what the Torah says, this is what Rabbele says, and this is why Torah specifies to tell you that Jews who think that by converting, by being reformed, leaving the Torah, they will be saved. The Torah says no. All of them will be burned, also the dung. Amazing, this is what he said, and this is what happened. Now, unbelievable, is this table that you are going to see now shows that all this happened, because it is very, very significant table. When I saw it, I was amazed. I could not believe it. Why? So what I was looking for? I was looking for the best meeting of the red cow, or the called red heifer, with Holocaust. So this is what the Torah gave me. It could not come in one sentence. So here we have the Parah Aduma, the red cow, the red heifer. And then we have here very small skip of Holocaust. In the Holocaust, Holocaust, unbelievable, emphasizing. Holocaust. Now, so what happened in the Holocaust? I never saw such a phenomenon that the name of Hitler, Yimach Shmo, comes here four times. Hitler, Hitler, Hitler. Unbelievable. Yeah? So, how it can be? So you can see four times. Hitler, 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 Hitler. Even here is Aleph Hitler. Aleph Hitler is Adolf Hitler. Unbelievable. Never saw such a thing that in one table you have four times the same name, Hitler, with a Nazi, Nazi camps, and Amalekites. They are the Amalekites, the cruel people want to wipe out Israel, to the Iran. Yeah, so Amalekites comes. Now, all this happened in the year. Unbelievable comes on the time, the 8, 5, 7, 101. It is about 1940, 1941. Around this area it was, yeah. It's 8 of Shin Aleph, right? In fact, we read in the Torah also the portion Kitisa. Kitisa, also the letter Tisa, are also the same here. And according to the pupil of the Baal Shem Tov, it indicates to a time that Israel could have Messiah if they will keep the Torah, because this is what Torah says, Kitisa et Rosh Bnei Israel, when you will lift up the head of Israel, of Jews. So this will be the time of the Messiah. That's the whole world, this is the word HaMashiach. That the whole world will realize the greatest of Jews, God. But also the Midrash says that lifting up the head can be opposite, cutting the head. This is what happened in the Holocaust. So this is what the Torah says. If Jews will keep the Torah, then Tisa et Rosh will lift up the head. And Tisa, Tav Shin Aleph, is exactly this year. So it means this year could be a year of Messiah. But unfortunately, it was a reform, yeah, and they definitely did not keep the Torah, they cut off verse from the Torah, got loss of the Torah, and the Haskalah, the Enlightenment movement, which also did not accept the Torah. And this was the rabbi said, and they said, you just translate the you are transgressing the Torah, Shabbos, and so on, so will come somebody and will bring the Holocaust. Unbelievable, everything is written. I wrote a book, you can see my book, The Holocaust in Bible and in Torah Code, which I wrote with Professor Aralik together. You can get it in Amazon.com, you can see it in Kindle, and also in my Sag Lesson books. Unbelievable, you can see clearly how all the rabbis said and wrong and threatened the Jews. You are translating the Torah, you translate the Shabbos, then you see what an Holocaust will come. It's an amazing table. in which I look for the red cow and the Holocaust. As Rabbi Ele said, Rabbi Ele Lapin, as he so said clearly, I heard it. I was in the yeshiva for Hasidim, but also come in his book. So we missed the time of Messiah. Mashiach could come in this year, Tisa. Lifting up the head could be lifting up the head, showing to the world the greatness of Jews. But unfortunately, because of the reform, because of Enlightenment movement of Skalam, who was against the Torah, made fun of Jews. So this was the result, Holocaust. In the time of Purim, the same thing was. Also was the danger of Holocaust. This was Haman wanted to do. Haman, Hitler is reincarnation of Haman. But at that time, the people listened to the rabbis, Mordechai and Esther. When they heard about the decree that is going to come because they transgressed the Torah, they fasted, they prayed, and it turned to be Purim. Yeah. So at that time was Purim, Pur, and today is Para. It is very interesting that Kabbalistically, the letter Pei Resh, power, represents very, very strong judgment. And what happened in Purim is the power, this is what Bnei Sachar said, that the power was split and taken away by the letter Vav. Because in Hebrew, the source of Purim is Pei Vav Resh, Pur. So the Vav, which represents holiness, sanctity, and represents unity, it broke the great danger of the power. But in Para, in the Holocaust, in Germany, it came to Para. Pei Resh, the power came together with the letter A representing the five aspects of judgment. Unbelievable. So interesting that you have here the word Samael, twice. Samael, known to be the heavenly minister of the Amalekite. Yeah? Also, Samael means according to our rabbis to do with the left, small. Yeah? Which in power, which try to take away the divine providence, yeah? Don't like to see that God will not look at what is going on. Democracy, they want to do everything what they want. Now, according to the Gematria, the numerical value of Samael, if you can see, it's 60, 40, 100, Aleph Lam, and 31, which is exactly the numerical value of Eichmann. Eichmann also, Aleph is 1. Yud Yud 20, 21, Memnon 90, 131, unbelievable. This is a Samael, this is Eichmann. Yeah, he was this one who was a butcher, yeah, who killed so many Jews. So important, very important table, which confirms what Rabele says, that this burning of the four parts of Jews, yeah, this is exactly what happened in the Holocaust.